Hey everyone, Kane here. I have decided to do my account review from time to time, so people can expect what they can have at certain points in the game. I know, I have spent money, so this review is not technically for free to play players. But it is possible to reach my power, or even higher, by a VIP 3 at minimum. Anything less may have about 200,000 plus or so difference, most likely most of it in artifacts. So, let's begin. We will first start with my formation. In here, you can see I have 8 rosters in my formation. Yes, even though I am preaching to have less rosters, I am using 8. That is because my rosters are well developed enough for me to be able to use a little bit more, but even so, some units are weak. What I can do to improve is to remove Ogre and replace him with Centaur, more likely when Centaur get his awakening released. A Centaur already can have around 60 to 70% damage reduction, which is increased even more after awakening, or some better buffs added onto the unit. That will remove one roster from my formation, and make Dendroid stronger as well, as I could focus the stronghold units into some better rosters. Angel, you do not really need a roster for this unit. Yes, it is an offensive unit, yes it should be doing damage. But, for me, I do not need this unit to do damage. I need this unit to heal the formation based on their own max health percent, revive dead allies and also stun the enemy, preferably not the backline first few seconds in the match. If the angel does not kill my devil early by stunning enemy backline, usually that is like 25% chance, then it is a plus to have this unit on your field, currently. If you are playing Inferno, that is Phoenix, the non-awakened version of this unit was so bad, this unit was not used, skipped and deemed literally useless by most of the community, that even when his awakening released, almost no one or a very handful of people raised him, and then we had the chance to see what this unit can become. Which is why he deserves a spot in my formation. He is close to 6 stars, and I have already bought 200 awakened shards to make Phoenix awakened 6 stars after I rank it up. Damage is insane to the backline units, complements devil when he jumps to the backline to ensure more devil ultimate triggers. And now, for my infernos. Devil is 5 stars, does not one-shot backline, but he is top 1 damage dealer, all the time. If he ends up dying everywhere 1 minute after, even Phoenix and Ifriti combined without dying, usually don't outmatch 5 star devil damage. In the next devil altar, I plan to make him 6 stars, and add some potential in there too. Ifriti, he is a buffer, more than a damage dealer to me, at least at the current moment in the game. Pitfiend, by far, is the best healer in this game. And she will only get better and better. She can single-handedly win matches by just placing one heal fountain, and most of the fights she ends up healing from 10 million to 25 million health. And Demon. Demon is a one-of-a-kind dodge and heal tank. There are others, but Demon is able to tank massive amounts of damage, from which about 80% is dodged and not counted in the status reports. His own heals from dodging are just insane. Most of the time, my Demon is nearly full HP tanking 2 to 3 units. And once potential is quite high, he starts appearing in top 3 damaged charts, sometimes lower. I have seen him top 3 quite a few times having 4 units that are able to do damage. I still can improve this formation here and there. Mostly want to reduce the amount of rosters in the formation by taking out my weakest, Ogre. I will be upgrading Angel to 4 or 5 stars whenever the altar appears, to make back the healing buff lost from Ogre. And, after that, mostly focusing on upcoming Inferno units, trying to save big amounts of diamonds. Now that's finished. We can move from the left to the right. Starting with Crypt. I have Giant, and I have Storm Elemental 4 star. I have not really went back to this event after I have made a YouTube video, which was a few weeks ago. I just want the maximum rewards, and I am happy. So the next couple of days, that is probably what I will be trying to do. Moving on to Dwarf Treasury. I am rank 1 on my server, and my score is 4788. One time I had it just a little bit over 4800, but the game scammed me, yet again, and removed about 16 dwarfs from my score to put me on the maximum I have now. For these both events now, I am using Jello. If you improve the hero, you can easily increase your scores for this event a little bit more. Moving on to rosters. Here you can see how well I have made most of them. My core are Inferno, Defensive, Offensive rosters, following after that are Caster and Rampart. The rest, because they are providing for only one unit or such, not really worth to upgrade very high until you upgrade what would be a better priority, which is a roster that would buff 2 to 4 units or so. My core roster is Inferno, as most people I play with know already. I have 4 units on my field, will have more in the future, upgrading this to maximum. Defensive, you will always need to use 3 or so tanks to achieve maximum results. Any less, and your backline will be non-existent, and you kind of need it for buffs, heals, and that sort of stuff. So defensive roster is a must-have for everyone. My third best is offensive. It wasn't third best until I accidentally clicked 10 gold key pull one morning when I was sick, and I received a bone dragon. That was the 6th addition to my offensive roster and bumped it above casters. Thus me also prioritizing them more afterwards. As Devil is my main DPS, Angel and Pit Fiend are sort of utility offensive units. In the future, it looks like Inferno composition that I am planning to have will contain 3 defensive, 4 offensive and 1 caster units total in my formation. Of which, 7 will be Inferno. So, I have my priorities in the right places. The rest of the rosters are just like something to fill until I get all the things I need for my future planned formation. I am not sure how many diamonds in total I will need to do it, but after that I may try and do a second formation and build some ramparts, not because they are strong, but because I like their units in general. But that's just me. Heading on over to my artifacts. Now some of these may be very low level on my account, but a lot higher in yours. Personally, raising them now instead of later seems like a waste for me. Sure, health percent is on entire field, but for me personally, it was better to get Devil, a huge damage dealer, to 5 star with all the diamonds I have saved, instead of provide all field with health. Same for damage green artifact, I level them, but not upgrading the core skill. The only artifact that you need to plus 20 as soon as you can is called Wizard's Well. It increases your mana regeneration, and at the same time, reduces enemy mana regeneration. Yes, you need it. Even if you think you don't, you need it. A lot. Not even a question, or an excuse to anyone. Once these last pieces hit plus 20, this artifact instantly jumps to plus 20. All others, I am just upgrading with whatever resources I am able to get from free daily pulls, campaign, dragon invasion. I stopped spending diamonds for astrology after I have reached 400,000 power on artifacts. And this is how far I've gotten thus far. They don't look spectacular yet, but most of them do their part. Dragon artifact, I have unlocked it on day 50 to 52, and at day 100 or so, I am very close to get it to level 2. It would have been faster, but instead of buying Hawkeye artifact, I bought it with orange tears, some pieces of it, just to unlock it, as the points it provides for your field were too good to pass out on. What I did was based more on doing my best to get and keep high arena rankings, which I am still on, most of the time top 3, top 4. In terms of heroes, there is not much to say about it yet. I am using the blue guy, it is 4 stars, but please, for the love of God, unless the hero is fixed, do not, and I mean please, do not upgrade this hero to 4 star, you will lose 150 universal shards and weaken this hero. I did not increase in damage, and I think I even decreased it by upgrading this hero to 4 stars. In terms of mastery, I am using mana regeneration, skill level plus 3, air cooldown reduction, and increased offense on your front line. Pretty basic cookie cutter skills on a mage hero. When it comes to units, I am very hard focusing on upgrading my demon. He has right now around 1200 plus shards in his potential, others less. Phoenix close to 6 star, 6 star awakened. Most others are close to 5 or so stars, some close to 6 stars, many others leveled 4 Oster bonuses, or events. I pretty much have only one formation and I stick to it, adjusting it slightly depending on how enemy formation is set up. My plans for the future improvements are, reduce my rosters in my formation by 1, removing stronghold faction and adding a second rampart tank. Saving diamonds to upgrade angel from 3 star, to 4 or 5 star, to make up for the healing loss. Upgrade devil to 6 star and add some potential, save the rest of my diamonds for future upcoming units and their awakens. To completely max them out as they appear. There are a few bits and pieces here and there, but these are my core plans. Hopefully more events do appear in the game so my grind is not long and boring. Thanks for watching, I hope you guys are safe, and I will see you in the next video.